the LGB20 user here, and today I'm doing a video about Virgin Mobile guys. They have now finally got limited bring your own phone thing here, so that's pretty good, I guess. I'm on prepaidfinish.com reading as the article here. So Virgin Mobile is now allowing to bring limited devices to their network here. So that's really good. So they're basically taking the page from Boost Mobile's book on that. Boost Mobile recently allowed you to bring certain phones from like Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile, and whatnot. But it's only a limited phones. You can't bring every phone from Verizon, AT&T, T-Mobile, whatever, to Boost or whatever. But you can bring some of them, guys, like the iPhones and stuff like that. So let's go check it out, guys. So it's about damn time, alright? Says in telecom, bring your own phone means allowing customers to use the capable phones they already own on your service. Sprint's the smallest of the four national U.S. carriers has long resisted to bring your own phone for no good reason that the person that read his article could see. The other three national carriers have embraced bring your own phone more or less enthusiastically, while Sprint has stirred up all sorts of roadblocks against it. You can't use a phone sold by, you can't use a phone sold for Sprint postpaid on Sprint prepaid or Virgin Mobile. You can only use a limited number of Sprint phones on Boost. Using a phone sold for one Sprint prepaid brand such as Boost on a different Sprint prepaid brand like Virgin Mobile is strictly prohibited. None of these restrictions makes technical sense, as Sprint postpaid phones and the phone sold for all three paid of Sprint's prepaid brands support the same network technologies and brands. Says the next paragraph says, yesterday Sprint quietly opened bring your own phone door a tiny bit. You can use certain iPhone models like I mentioned, and the unlike special edition version of the Samsung Galaxy S7 and the Galaxy S7 Edge sold by Best Buy on Virgin Mobile. Here are a capable list of 9 Virgin Mobile phones that can be used on Virgin Mobile. iPhone 7, Verizon only. iPhone 7 Plus, Verizon only. iPhone SE, Verizon only. iPhone 6S, iPhone 6S Plus. iPhone 6, iPhone 5S, Verizon only. iPhone 5C, Verizon only. Samsung Galaxy S7 Special Edition. Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge Special Edition. Alright, so those are the phones that you can use on Virgin Mobile right now. It says, bizarrely, you still can't use the Sprint or Boost Mobile iPhones or the Sprint Galaxy S7 or S7 Edge and Virgin. Sprint also seems to be making activation of 9 Virgin Mobile phones as difficult as possible. They aren't selling SIMs online. Even if you already have or manage to obtain a Sprint SIM, you can't activate on Virgin Mobile online or by calling Virgin Mobile Customer Care. The only way to activate one of these 10 phones listed above on Virgin Mobile is by taking it to a Sprint dealer or a Radio Shack store. A $10 SIM purchase is required. Bring your own phone devices can be activated on either Virgin Mobile's two current monthly plans, $35 plan with 5 GB of high-speed data or $45 plan with 10 GB of high-speed data. Sprint is struggling financially and has the smallest and slowest network. You would think they would want to make it easy as possible for potential customers to get their phones on the Sprint network. Allowing some non-Virgin Mobile phones on Virgin, even with all restrictions, is a step in the right direction, but Sprint needs to do more to encourage bringing in phone, which would help them to gain badly needed customers. To start with, Sprint should get rid of the ban using Boost phones on Virgin and vice versa. It makes no sense technically or financially, forcing customers to buy a phone, to buy a new subsidized phone to switch from one prepaid Sprint brand to another is expensive for both the consumer and for Sprint. It frustrates and angers customers and encourages them to find a different operator that isn't so restrictive. Yeah, and that makes sense, man. The person who wrote this article said that they sort of understand the reasoning behind blocking postpaid phones and prepaid. They think Sprint management fears that if they allow postpaid users to use their phones one less expensive prepaid. Many prepaid customers make the switch to prepaid, hurting Sprint bottom line, but they believe the reason is flawed. Once a customer has run the numbers and determined that they can save money with prepaid, they have already made up their mind to make the switch. Sprint has lost that customer as a postpaid customer, but they can still have the chance to keep them as a prepaid customer. Allowing the customer switching to prepaid to use their current plan gives the customer an incentive to stay with the Sprint prepaid brand. AT&T, T-Mobile, and Verizon all simply understand and allow users switching from postpaid to prepaid to keep their phones. Sprint does not, and the person who wrote this article believes that that's typical of the clueless management that made Sprint number 4. So if you guys are on Virgin Mobile and you guys want to bring a non-Virgin Mobile phone to Virgin Mobile, you guys can do it now. I don't know if you, let's say if you have an iPhone 6 on AT&T or whatever. I don't know if you have to finish up the paint. I don't know if you have to finish paying off the phone installment plan or whatever. You probably want to finish paying off the phone installments before you can actually bring these phones over, because that's what Sprint one did. That's what the Virgin Mobile did. Boost Mobile now allows you to bring certain phones, non-Boost Mobile phones, to Boost Mobile, like the iPhone 7 from Verizon and all that good stuff. But they say that you have to finish paying up your phone installments before you can actually bring it over. So you would have to get to a Sprint store. You would have to get to a Boost Mobile store to activate a non-Boost Mobile phone on Boost. But for Virgin Mobile, it's a bit different. You have to go to a Sprint store or a Radio Shack guy, so keep that in mind. And you can use your phones above here. They're mostly iPhones here. The iPhone 7 and the iPhone 7 Plus are the newest phones on this list. The S7 and the S7 Edge are Samsung flagship phones for 2016, obviously. And the iPhone 5C is crap. The iPhone 5S is still alright. That will get iOS 10 if it hasn't gotten it already. iPhone 6 is still pretty good. The 6S Plus, obviously, the 6S will still get a couple more updates. So, it's about time that Virgin Mobile allows you to bring certain non-Virgin Mobile phones to Virgin Mobile, but it's only limited right now. But I don't know if you have to finish paying off your phone and some of the things or not before you can actually bring the phones over. But I think this is a good idea, and hopefully that it will open the door to more phones. Like, hopefully they'll allow to bring a LG V20 to Virgin Mobile. That'd really be cool, you know what I'm saying? The V20 is a nice phone, and I have it for Verizon, and it's a great phone. Best phone for 2016, in my opinion. About time the Virgin Mobile family lets you bring your own phone. It's a limited number, but 10 is better than nothing. And hopefully that it will expand as time goes on. And hopefully that, I'm sure it'll probably satisfy Virgin Mobile customers or potential Virgin Mobile customers. Hey, I got an iPhone 7 on Verizon, and I could take it to Virgin Mobile if I wanted to. But like I said, I don't know if you have to finish paying off your phone installments. I'm pretty sure that you would have to. So just keep that in mind. It's a good about time, Virgin Mobile, that you allow your customers to bring their own phones and shit like that. It's about damn time. If you guys enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up, guys. It really helps me out a lot. Please rate, comment, subscribe. Thank you very much for watching my video, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.